Let's explore more of this whole drawing thing. What can we make besides rectangles? Well, we can make ovals using the word ellipse, which is another command the computer knows. We actually have a special programming word for commands. We're going to call them functions. I'll be using the word function from now on just to mean command. So we'll go ahead and write the function name ellipse, and then two parentheses and a semicolon. And it's not working. We have this error message talking about parameters, whatever those are. Can you see what we're missing by comparing what we just wrote with rect? Well, right, when we just type ellipse, we aren't telling it the numbers like we did for the rectangle. These numbers here are called parameters. And we say that we pass parameters into functions, and they control how the function behaves. So without the parameters, the program doesn't know where you want your ellipse or how big to make it. So now that error message makes a little more sense. Let's go ahead and pass in four parameters again to control how far over, how far down, how wide, and how tall we want that ellipse to be. And just like before, we can have some fun and move around our ellipse, and even make it, you know, grow and shrink. Alright, so now that we've seen the basics, let's try drawing a big ellipse right in the middle of the canvas. Well, the first question you might have is, like, where's the middle again? So, just to review, we have this upper left is 0, then the right, if you remember, is 400, and then the bottom is 400 as well. So if we think, okay, where would the middle be? We would say, okay, well, it's going to be half of 400 over, so 200, and then half of 400 down, so 200. And we can go ahead and do that. So let's make our ellipse function, and we'll pass the parameters in, make it really pretty big. Well, there it is. All right, now just for fun, let's put a rectangle there too. So we'll say rect, 200, 200 as well, maybe a little bit smaller. And, this is actually kind of interesting. What does this little experiment show us? Well, we can see that that 200, 200 point is actually saying where we should put the center of the ellipse. But for rectangles, it's different. Because for rectangles, the 200, 200 says where we should put this upper left corner of the rectangle. And that's really important to remember when we're trying to position our shapes. Okay, now let's move on to simple lines. That function name is just going to be line. We can pass it four parameters again. But I guess a line doesn't really have a size like a rectangle, does it? So what will these numbers control? Well, first and the second parameters, just like before, say how far over and down the line should start. Whereas the second two parameters, the second set of parameters, the 90 and the 200, are going to specify how far over and how far down the line should end. Okay, so now that we understand how that works, let's look at something that's going to seem really weird at first. What happens if I go ahead and I make this rectangle start in that upper left corner, and again, specifying that upper left corner of the rectangle as well, and then really big? And we can even make it that big, but that's like a little bit too big, I think. So we see that we're actually starting to make that ellipse disappear. We actually make it disappear completely. And now we're kind of wondering where it went. What the program does is it actually draws your shapes in order. So first it draws that ellipse, then it draws that rectangle on top, and then it draws the line. So that ellipse is still there, it's just, as you saw, underneath. And this is an important point to remember, because what would happen if, say, you know, we drew our line first? Well, we just wouldn't see it at all, would we? And you might do that in your programs and wonder, hey, where did my line go? And the idea is that, well, it is there, it's just being hidden right now, both by the ellipse and also, you know, by that rectangle. So we can just affect which shapes are drawn on top of which other shapes just by changing the order that we write them in our program. All right. Now, I just want to introduce a couple of technical terms before we finish. Just like you might have learned in math, we can use the letter X just to mean how far over like we've been talking about, and the letter Y to mean how far down. That might seem a little bit weird if you're not used to it, but it's just a little bit easier to say than how far over and how far down every single time. So the first two parameters to our ellipse, for example, are saying that X should be at 200 and Y should be like 229. And there you have it. Just the same thing as saying how far over and how far down. Now, a second really good question you might have are like, what units have we been using this whole time? Are we saying like 200 centimeters, 200 inches, 200 miles? Well, we're using units called pixels. And a pixel is a tiny little point on your screen. This canvas actually happens to be 400 pixels wide. And that's why we always say that this upper left corner is 0, and then over here is going to be 400, because it's 400 pixels. And then similarly, when we say 200, we actually mean 200 pixels, and you probably get the idea. So fantastic. Now you know all about the functions line, ellipse, and rect, and their parameters. We covered a lot, but just stick with it, keep exploring, and you'll get the hang of it soon.